Welcome back, YouTube, to the Culture of Currency, the channel dedicated to showing you, the viewer, that anyone can start and enjoy a silver coin collection. Of course, we do it here by making small purchases of around $100 to show that most anyone can start and maintain this hobby. We also bring you unboxings and coin-specific ratings and reviews, like the video today over the 1-ounce silver St. Lucia Flamingo coin. Please remember to subscribe so that one day we will be a monetized channel and my wife will let me continue to bring you fresh and exciting content. Let's dive into the reason for this video. If you watched the unboxing where my wife selected the coins, you would note that this coin is from that purchase. This coin is one that she apparently really wanted me to have, and though it is not my favorite coin by far, has actually grown on me. Let's dive into the culture of where this coin hails from and then get into the coin itself. St. Lucia is an island nation that is very close to Barbados and St. Kitts and has a similar story. I have videos on coins from those islands if you're interested. It is thought that the Arawakan people found the shores of St. Lucia around 200 to 400 AD. Just like Mediterranean anthropologists and archaeologists, the researchers used styles of pottery to most closely tie a date to the early people of that land. All was well in the land for quite a while until the more violent Caribs showed up around 800 AD. So after about 400 years of happiness, the Caribs crashed the party, killing all the males and subjecting the females to assimilation. After more time passed, it is said that Columbus spotted the island on his fourth voyage in 1502. In a related story, when I used to perform duties at the Vatican, I remember a great haul of tapestried maps. As the known world expanded through cartography and exploration, the maps developed. I remember that Rome was always at the center of these tapestries, and when the Western exploration began, the maps would show rough layouts of the coastal shores of the Americas. I now wonder if what I was looking at were tapestries showing Columbus's travels in real time. The island is currently as pleasant as you could expect, with average highs in the 80s and lows in the 70s. The capital holds a geographically natural harbor, which is rare, and the island elevation alone brings diversity of fauna, so that is something great to behold. The economy thrives on tourism, which usually means it is a presentable and hospitable place for visitors. It is noted, however, that oil and bananas are also very high in their GDP chart. Even with the industry of economics functioning at a high level, this little island holds around a 20% unemployment rate and brings the average household income to under $20,000 annually. This is an island that I hope to travel to myself one day. My plan is to island hop in the Lesser Antilles so that I could really see the differences in cultures and form a higher respect for the native people. Now that we've covered a little bit about the island, let's get into the coin and put it to our 60-point scale. This coin is produced by the Eastern Caribbean Bank Program, or EC8. This program consists of 4 coins minted each year on behalf of each of the 8 Caribbean island members and comprise the ECCB. And they are Anguilla, Antigua, Barbuda, the Commonwealth of Dominica, Grenada, Montserrat, St. Kitts and Nevis, St. Lucia, and St. Vincent and the Grenadines. The ECCB is the official issuer of the Eastern Caribbean dollar, the currency of the EC8 program since it began in 2018. I'm interested in your opinions about the coins from this program. Please let me know in the comments which of these listed are your favorite. You may have to go research them at AtMex or some other place. On the front we have, once again, the Queen. I do not condone violence or want any revolutionary talks, but wish that the Queen would be a small portion of the coin, giving the designers the ability to highlight other items about their country that could bring in some tourism interest or historical significance. It should be a point of pride. Just like other coins in the minting program, I score the front to 6. It's the exact same as many of the others, but offers a touch of class with the rim and foliage, which brings it above the average standard 5 for a queen coin. When we look at the back of the coin, we see what my research and knowledge indicates is a nesting pair of flamingos. They are in silhouette at the sun's set, and the tide kind of moves in and out. Both birds have the iconic one leg up, as the bird on the left looks up and the bird on the right looks down. It is noted that this artwork, like many in the series, change every single year. I think that it is rather well done coin. They have used the entire space as a canvas and have paid excellent attention to balance of negative space and with subtle detailing and feature a refreshing scene. This is not an overwhelming image, but it is well done, so I scored an 8. Mintage is set at 25,000, which I find to be a very happy medium for many of the coins I see. It is nice to know there are not hundreds of thousands of these out there, and there are not so few that the premium is outrageous, so this scores an 8 as well. When it comes to cultural significance, the American flamingo is a bird that can be found throughout the islands of the Caribbean. It is a scene that I think captures the tropics the islands offer and makes it a desirable place to want to visit. I think that it is solid, but not overwhelming in significance, as it shows the calm nature of the island. I give it an 8. Collectability is our next category. We have a coin that changes artwork every single year. That alone is a great thing for collectors. We, however, have subject matter that is a little less desirable to many of the population, even though the coins I have seen are beautiful and detailed. I think it should hold a 7 in this category. Our last category is uniqueness. This is a coin that, as stated, changes every single year. The artwork provides a sense of uniqueness, however, there have been many nations produce coins with subject matter of flamingo. All of that being said, I think we must give this coin a 7 for uniqueness. It would be lower if the artwork did not change every year. This brings our total score to a 43 out of 60, which I find fairly respectable for a flamingo. This puts these birds on par with the Royal Arms of Great Britain, which scored a 43, the Australian Kangaroo, which scored a 43, and the BVI Pegasus, British Virgin Islands, which scored a 43, just to give you some reference of where these birds land. And looking at the totality of this coin, I find that this is a great coin for my collection, but could see why it would be low on the list for others. Please remember to comment what you think about this coin and the other coins that we mentioned about the EC8, and remember to stay classy and current with the culture of currency.